8 quizzes are squaring up to do battle in the tournament. But who has what it takes to knock the competition for 6 and become champion? Well, we're about to find out. Scott, and welcome to the tournament, a knockout game where general knowledge, quick thinking, and staying calm under pressure are vital if you want to win. Let's meet today's players.
I'm Elizabeth, originally from California. I'm a graduate student at Oxford, and I'm aiming for a first-class win today on the run.
I'm Paul, an airline pilot from Surrey. Last time, I was a losing finalist. This time, my final destination is the Golden Run.
I'm Jenny from Aberdeen. I worked in casinos for many years, and you can bet I'm odds on favourite today.
I'm Asim, a civil engineer from Manchester. My favourite TV show is The Big Bang Theory, and today I'll be making a big bang in the tournament.
I'm Ian, an actor from Doncaster, and today I'm going to win the award for Best Quizzer.
I'm Irene from Liverpool. I'm an audience experience host, and I'm going to show everyone why I'm the hostess with the mostess.
I'm Chantal from Hampshire. I'm head of fundraising at work, but today I'm here to raise funds just for me.
I'm Lawrence from Hampshire. I'm so competitive, I used to cheat at Monopoly with my brother, but today I'm aiming to win this fair and square.
Hello and welcome, everyone. Good bunch of battle cries going on once again, and I wonder which one of you is going to be our champion today, because Paul,
hello.
You were so close last time.
Close but no cigar.
The destination now to that Golden Run?
Hopefully Golden Run, let's see.
Okay, well, we will find out, because Ian, welcome. Tell us a bit about yourself.
I'm an actor from Doncaster.
So here to steal the show today?
Yeah, that's what I'm hoping so, and I'm a man of many voices and many talents. Let's hope I can add quiz into the number.
OK, but Jenny over here, we know you're good with a good poker face.
Sometimes.
Sometimes? What, you work in casinos?
I did work in casinos, yeah.
OK.
Cruise ships and things, been around the world, and now I'm a train driver, so
okay.
Bit of a difference, but the skills are still there.
They're still there, mm-hmm. Looking to be a bit of a high roller today, then.
I hope so.
OK, well, it's time to get cracking, everyone, and first up, we need to create that leaderboard. So I'm going to be asking 8 questions. The smartest and the fastest will find themselves in pole position, which means banking the most cash and having the power to choose who you take on and take out in the knockout matches. Is everyone ready?
Yeah. Yes.
OK, let's do this. Let's play. Question 1. According to the International Bartenders Association, which herb is used in a mojito cocktail? Thyme, mint, basil, rosemary? All locked in, and the answer is mint. Ooh, and that is mint right there. Full house. Okay, question 2. In the UK, which month is Black History Month? June, August, October, November? All locked in, and the answer is October. Oh, see, this is where things change. 4 right, 4 wrong. Here we go. Things started to get interesting. Question 3. The national flag of which of these countries does not feature a cross? Iceland, Greece, Latvia, Switzerland? And the answer is Latvia. Oh, 2 of you right there. Irene.
I'm half Greek as well, but Cypriot, so, you know.
Question 4. Who starred alongside Dwayne Johnson in the 2021 Disney film Jungle Cruise? Emily Blunt, Gal Gadot, Scarlett Johansson, Rachel Weisz? And the answer is Emily Blunt. Ian, our actor.
Not seen that one, unfortunately.
No? Don't really know your Hollywood?
I think I'm more used to seeing Dwayne Johnson as a wrestler than his acting career.
OK. Question 5. Who was the Prime Minister of the UK on the 1st of January 1980? James Callaghan, Harold Wilson, John Major, Margaret Thatcher? All locked in, and the answer is Margaret Thatcher. 6 of you got that right. Don't forget, there's £1,000 at stake here. Question 6. The mazurka is a traditional dance from which European country? Poland, Germany, France, Denmark. All locked in? And the answer is Poland. Everyone's in the green.
A full house.
Question 7. What colour is the E on the standard Google logo? Red, green, blue, yellow. All locked in? And the answer is red.
Ooh. Like me.
You are in the red. Not the only one, though. Last question, question 8. In metres, how high above the pitch is the top edge of the crossbar on a set of full-size rugby goalposts? 2, 3, 4, 6. All locked in? And the answer is 3. 4 of you hit the post for that one. But it was the last question, all complete. We'll see how things play out on the leaderboard. Let's start down there at the bottom, and with a crisp tenner and 4 correct answers is Irene. Ian is in 7th, Paul is in 6th, Chantal is in 5th, Lawrence is in 4th. Then we have a run of 7 correct answers. Jenny, Asim, but the fastest of the 7s, and so top of the table right now with £1,000, it is you, Elizabeth. Congratulations.
Wow.
I mean, you seemed a bit shocked.
I was not expecting this, but...
But that's the thing, things change so quickly in this game.
It's redemption.
Yes, and £1,000 right up there.
Oof.
Right, we've got our rankings, and now we start our head-to-head matches on the tournament run in the ultimate quizzing tug of war. All matches will last up to 2 minutes. Each correct answer pushes your opponent a step back towards the red knockout zone. Whoever pushes their opponent closest to the red zone will be the winner, and they will steal their opponent's money and qualify for the next round. And the loser, we will be saying goodbye because they will be eliminated. If you do push your opponent all the way into the red, just like the blue is doing right now, you will get a knockout, earning you some bragging rights and a cheeky £500 bonus. Okay, Elizabeth, you are in pole position right up there at the top of the leaderboard.
It feels good. It feels good.
Well, you are in control right now. You get to decide who you are looking to take on and take out. What's the game plan today?
I don't know. I was thinking it would be really funny if I did the old grudge match and picked Lawrence from the previous episode. But I think I'm changing it up this round, and I've gone with Irene.
Irene, you are locked in.
I just knew it.
Okay, Elizabeth, you get to choose the category. You have film and TV, history, music, places, sports and games, food and drink, celebs and pop culture.
I'm going to go with history.
History is locked in.
Predictable.
Oh, God.
Irene, no? What, do you want to walk home now, or are you going to put up a bit of a fight down here?
I do food and drink. I go to restaurants every week, and I know a lot about that.
Right, you two, it is time for kickoff. It's Elizabeth v. Irene in the category history. Irene, it's an A-star performance from you right now.
Oh, God, I'm saying nothing. I'm just going to go for it.
OK, well, let's find out who the favourite is. All our players faced a pre-tournament test of their general knowledge, and based on their scores, I can reveal that the favourite for this head-to-head in history is Elizabeth. Elizabeth, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Irene, are you ready?
Yeah.
You have 2 minutes on the clock, starting in. A major figure in the Cuban Revolution of the... Elizabeth?
Che Guevara.
Correct. Which four-letter word beginning with T is a loose, flowing outer robe worn by people... Irene?
Toga.
Correct. What was the surname of the US president who came both before and after Bill Clinton? Irene? Out of time. Throw over.
Bush.
Correct. A great earthwork built in the 8th century, which lies between England and Wales, is known as Offa's what? Out of time, dyke. In which country was the engineer Gustave Eiffel born? Elizabeth.
France.
Correct. In which major industrial British city in the northwest of England was a ship canal constructed in... Irene?
Liverpool.
Incorrect. Throw over. In 1893. Out of time, Manchester. Mm. The names of which two coins go together to describe a type of bicycle popular in the 1870s? Out of time, penny and farthing. The NHS was founded under the Prime Minister Clement who? Elizabeth.
Davies.
Incorrect, throw over. Out of time, Attlee. In the 1960s, fashion designer Mary Quant popularised which type of short skirt beginning with M? Irene?
Miniskirt.
Correct. In Greek mythology, which H was the ruling god of the underworld? Elizabeth?
Hades.
Correct. Which country's first female prime minister? It would have been Australia. It's a win for Elizabeth!
Woo! That was amazingly close.
I sound well in that.
Good fight between you two.
Yeah,
really close.
I'm proud of myself, I'm not going to lie.
Honestly,
what a battle. Irene, you feeling good about yourself now?
Yeah.
I like that. Even though the curtain has closed for you, I'm glad you are leaving with a smile. Thank you for coming on the tournament.
No worries.
Elizabeth, congratulations. You have just stolen Irene's £10, giving you a total right now of £1,010, and you're through to that semi-final. Well done.
Thank you.
Okay, SM, you are next up there on the leaderboard. You said your favourite TV show, Big Bang Theory.
Yeah, I do enjoy watching that. It's very sciencey, very techy.
Who are you looking to take on and take out?
It's a really difficult one because everyone's very, very strong and everyone's really good. But I'm thinking I'm going to go up against Jenny.
Jenny, you are locked in. A bit of an ooh right there.
I knew he would do that.
You did?
Oh, I absolutely knew he would do that.
How come?
I just had a feeling. It's getting the side eye.
Okay, let's look at the categories.
Well, I know that Jenny's good at places. I think I'm going to go with what my strong suit is, which is sports and games.
Sports and games it is. You told us on the last episode you like your football, a couple of other things as well.
I do.
Did you well as well?
Did.
OK. Jenny, how do you feel about this category?
Let's just hope a few questions go in my favour.
Well, we're about to find out because it's time for kickoff. It's Azim v Jenny in the category sports and games. Okay, Azim, you made it to the semi-final last time.
I did. I'm hoping to go one step further. Or two steps further, actually.
Okay. We need to find out who the favourite is in the category sports and games, and I can reveal that it is... Azim, it's you. Azim, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Jenny, are you ready?
I am ready.
You have 2 minutes on the clock, starting in... Which English city has major football teams named Forest and County? Jenny.
Nottingham.
Correct. In which sport is there a shout of seconds out just before the start of a round? Jenny.
Oh, pass, sorry.
Throw over.
Boxing.
Correct. Before Andy Murray, the last British man to win a Wimbledon singles title was Fred who? Azim.
Perry.
Correct. The fighting video game, which includes characters such as Jade, Sub-Zero and Johnny Cage, Azim?
Tekken.
Incorrect, they're over, is Mortal what?
Combat.
Correct. Which European national team won the men's FIFA World Cup in 2006? Azim?
Italy.
Correct. Kadena Cox won 2 gold medals at the 2020 Tokyo Olympics in which sport? Azim?
Gymnastics.
Incorrect, they're over.
Judo.
Incorrect. Cycling. Belfast Giants, Sheffield Steelers and Dundee Stars are all teams. Jenny?
Ice hockey.
Correct. Which word for rowing with an oar in each hand sounds like a part of the skeleton? Asim?
Cox.
Incorrect. Throw over.
Pass.
Skull. A smaller version of which sport is often described as crazy or mini? Asim?
Golf.
Correct. Alfie Hewitt is a three-time Paralympic silver medalist in which wheelchair racket sport? Asim?
Tennis.
Correct. What card game has the same name as the Italian word for one? Jenny?
Uno.
Correct. How many dice are used in a standard game of Yahtzee? Jenny?
Four.
Incorrect. Throw over.
Six.
Incorrect. Five. Also featuring white sleeves, Arsenal Football Club's home shirts are predominantly which primary colour? Jenny?
Red.
Correct. Team GB's only two medals in the 2022 Winter Olympics were for the men's and... It would have been curling, but right now it's time out and we have a tie. What a round. And that is how things stand. I see you were the favourite, but Jenny, look at that. It's a draw. So we are going to go into a tiebreaker. It's going to be the first person to give me the correct answer will be the winner, OK?
OK.
Edgbaston Cricket Ground is located, Asim?
Birmingham.
Correct! Ooh. Hey. How are you feeling?
Relieved. Very relieved.
That's how close that round was. Jenny, you did so well.
I knew that too. I just wasn't quick enough.
Oh.
About the only cricket question I know.
Well, it's time to go home, but thank you for being on the tournament, Jenny.
Thank you. Thank you,
thank you so much.
Well done. Woo!
I said, what can we say? So close, but a huge congratulations. You have stolen Jenny's £600, giving you a nice total of £1,350. And once again, you've made it to that semi-final. Well done.
Thank you very much.
OK, Lawrence, you've just seen how close things can get. You are next up on our leaderboard. And very competitive also.
Well, like I said, back in the day, you know, playing Monopoly against my brother Ben. But no, these days, a little more friendly. But I'm going to have to take on one of these people, aren't I?
You sure are.
And you'll understand when I choose the category. I'm not choosing the airline pilot pool. I'm going to go with Ian.
Ian, you are locked in. Lawrence, you get to decide the category, like you said.
I'm really tempted to go for music again, but I think I'm going to mix it up. And I'm going to go for places.
Places it is. Travel much?
Yeah, so I go abroad most winters for my music, so I'm hoping that Ian doesn't do that for his performing.
Ian, you travel around?
Yeah, and places is one of the subjects that is my strongest subject. Very, very happy with this.
Nice. Well, it's going to make for an interesting round, this one, isn't it? It's time for kickoff. It's Lawrence v Ian in the category places. Well, you're making your debut. Act one, scene one, right here.
Let's hope it's not exit stage left.
It's time to find out who the favourite is in the category places. And I can reveal that it is Lawrence. It's you. Little eyebrow raise there. Happy with that?
I'm a Barnsley fan. I'm used to being the underdog.
There's some tension out here. It's going to be a good one. Lawrence, are you ready?
Yes.
Ian, are you ready?
I am.
You have 2 minutes on the clock, starting in. Which British airport uses the three-letter code LHR? Ian?
London Heathrow.
Correct. Silicon Valley is located in which, Lawrence?
California.
Correct. The Canary Islands belong to which, Lawrence?
Spain.
Correct. The official currency of Switzerland is the Swiss, Lawrence?
Franc.
Correct. What sea is the name of the nearest French port to the British Isles? Ian?
Calais.
Correct. Which major Scottish city contains areas called Dean Village and Haymarket? Ian?
Edinburgh.
Correct. The Potomac River runs through which North American capital city? Lawrence?
Washington, D.C.
Correct. Beginning with A, which South American country's name means land of silver? Lawrence?
Argentina.
Correct. On the Australian Aboriginal flag, what primary colour is the circle which represents the sun? Ian?
Yellow.
Correct. Which Asian country with the capital New Delhi has... Lawrence?
India.
Correct. What tea is the name of the family of four art galleries located in Liverpool? Ian?
Tate.
Correct. The pyramids of Meroe are located in which African country? Ian?
Egypt.
Incorrect. They're over. Beginning with S.
Somalia.
Incorrect. Sudan. What is the only US state that's name begins with the letter G? Lawrence.
Georgia.
Correct. Truro is the only city. Ian?
Cornwall.
Correct. In terms of population, what H is the second largest city in Germany? Ian?
Hamburg.
Correct. What K is an Indonesian volcanic island located in?
Krakatoa.
Correct. Which historic English county is often known by its abbreviated form, Barks? Lawrence?
Berkshire.
Correct. And just like that, in the nick of time, Lawrence, Ian, it is a tie. Whew! Said it was going to be a good matchup between you two.
Yeah, it was. It was. It was very quick.
Okay.
I promised entertainment, so you know.
And you're bringing it. Once again, we are going to a tie break situation right here. First person to buzz in with the correct answer will be the winner. Ready? Located in Scotland, what sea is the largest national park in the... Ian?
Cairngorms.
Correct. Ian!
Well done, bud. Really well done, mate.
I've been.
On to the next scene.
Yeah, absolutely. That was a very good game. He's a very good player.
Very good game. Lawrence, wow. The favourite in that. That's what's amazing about this game. So close, that one. You played fair and square, but you did lose, Lawrence.
Yeah, well, I guess that's why being the banker of Monopoly is always a good thing, isn't it? You always just take as many as you want. But no, fair play to Ian. I hope he goes on to win it.
Oh, well, thank you for being on the tournament, Lawrence. Ian, congratulations. You've just stolen Lawrence's £400, giving you a nice total £450 and you're through to that semi-final. Well done.
Thank you.
Okay, Chantal, it's over to you. Next up there on our leaderboard, head of raising funds at work, but hoping to raise some funds for yourself today.
Well, let's hope so.
Let's hope so. You know who you are taking on.
I do, and he's going to be a formidable opponent, I fear.
Okay, well, let's lock Paul in. We know Paul got all the way to that final last time.
Yeah, he did.
You get to decide the category.
Yes.
So, we have film and TV, music, food and drink, celebs and pop culture.
Yeah, I mean, I quite like the look of all of them, to be fair, but I think I'm going to risk it and go for celebs and pop culture.
Celebs and pop culture. It is. Is that because Paul said he wasn't very good at that last time?
I can't remember what he said. I just think that out of those ones left, that might be his weakest. It's probably mine as well.
Paul, do you have a weakness?
We all have weaknesses. I don't mind that one at all.
Oh, OK.
Maybe I was playing a little bit of a game on the last show.
Well, we're about to find out who is playing a game right now. It's time for kickoff. It's Chantal v. Paul in the category Celebs and Pop Culture. Okay, things have been very tight so far with a couple of tie breaks and no knockouts. Paul, we know on the last episode you was hoping to win that cash, give it to your kids.
I was. Chantal's going to steal it from my kids now. I can't believe it.
Oh. Give it to mine. it won't go to my kids, it'll be mine.
Oh. Well, let's see who the favourite is in the category celebs and pop culture. I can reveal that it is Evan Stevens.
Oh. There we go. Mm.
Bit of a bluff then last time, Paul?
Maybe.
Chantal, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Paul, are you ready?
I'm ready.
You have 2 minutes on the clock, starting in... Danny Dyer began hosting which BBC primetime quiz show, Chantal?
The Wall.
Correct. In 1985, the Danish model and actress Bridget Nielsen married the US action, Chantal?
Sylvester Stallone.
Correct. You've Got to Laugh is a 2021 memoir by this morning presenter and I Can See Your Voice panellist, Alison Who? Chantal?
It's just gone, sorry.
Throw over.
Alison Moyet.
Incorrect, Alison Hammond. In OK Go's music video, Here It Goes Again, what item of home exercise equipment did the band perform on? Chantal?
A cycle.
Incorrect, throw over.
Treadmill.
Correct. Which singer's performance of Hound Dog on a US television show, Chantal?
Elvis.
I'll accept. In online retail, the letters in the acronym ASOS originally stood for as, Chantal?
As seen on screen.
Correct. In 2021, the artist Kanye West legally changed his name to what two-letter name? Out of time, yay. In which decade was Julia Roberts born? Chantal?
60s.
Correct. In reality TV, what word can follow Jersey and Geordie to give the name of two, Paul?
Sure.
Correct. The US singer born in 1949 and most associated with the E Street Band is Bruce who? Paul?
Springsteen.
Correct. How was the British singer-songwriter born David Jones in 19... Chantal?
David Bowie.
Correct. Which Spice Girl was awarded Female Spectacle Wearer of the Year in... Chantal?
Mel B.
Correct. Which one-word multinational company was founded by Richard Branson in 19... Paul?
Virgin.
Correct. Kravis is the name given to a celebrity couple. It would have been Kourtney Kardashian, but it's a win for Chantal.
Thank you very much.
You're
Thank
looking you. Down there.
That's like a...
You did it. You took out Paul, our former finalist.
Yeah, and I was quite nervous about taking him on, actually. I think he's quite a clever chap, but
clearly I'm cleverer.
Well, it was a good bluff, Paul. We know from before he was very cool, calm and confident. You've been great on the tournament. Well, thank you for coming on.
Beaten by the better person.
Well, and thank I wish you, all you luck. Paul.
Look at that. Chantal? Congratulations.
Thank you very much.
No need to be nervous right now. You are through to that semi-finals. You have stolen Paul's £100, giving you a total of £350, and we're going to see you in that semi-final. Well
Thank
done.
You. Thank you. Paul.
Well, we are now at the semi-final stage, so let's take a quick look and see how this tournament is playing out. And as it stands, in fourth, it's Chantal. In third, we have Ian. In second is Elizabeth, but right there at the top of the table, in pole position, it is you, Asim. Smiling away, congratulations.
Thank you very much. Just trying to do my best, so hopefully that'll carry on.
Okay, well, you know the aim of the game right now. You've got to look to take someone on and take them out for you to get to that final.
Indeed. And I think I'm going to go for Elizabeth.
Elizabeth, you are locked in.
I mean, formidable opponent, so here's hoping.
OK, depending on the category, which you have to decide. Asim, it's all on you. You have film and TV, music, food and drink.
I'm not really strong on any of them. However, I think film and TV is the one that I may be able to just about pass on, hopefully.
Are you going with that one?
I'm going to film and TV.
Film and TV it is. OK, Elizabeth, film and TV?
Let's hope that being from the same state as Hollywood pays off somehow.
Oh, OK. Well, hopefully this one's going to be a blockbuster, you two. It's time for kickoff in the first of our semi-finals. It's Asim v Elizabeth in the category film and TV. Asim, you got to the semi-final last time.
I did.
What category did you have?
Film and TV.
Asim, what category have you chosen now?
Film and TV. Hopefully better this time.
OK. Let's see who the favourite is, shall we, in the category film and TV. And I can reveal that it is Even Stevens.
Okay. Oh, man.
It's going to be an interesting one. This whole game has been very interesting. It's been close. Asim, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Elizabeth, are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
You have 2 minutes on the clock and your time starts in... Which 2003 British comedy drama film features Hugh Grant as a fictional UK Prime Minister? Elizabeth.
In the Loop.
Incorrect. They're over.
Love Actually.
Correct. The 2022 series Fight School, which teaches young people how to box, as in?
Idris Elba.
Correct. Cassandra is the wife of which character in the BBC comedy Only Fools and Horses? Asim?
Del Boy.
Incorrect. Throw over.
John.
Incorrect. Rodney. Colours of the Wind features on the soundtrack of which night? Elizabeth?
Pocahontas.
Correct. Which spy with initials JB? Elizabeth?
James Bond.
Incorrect. Throw over. Has been played in 4 films by the actor Matt Damon?
Jason Bourne.
Correct. Which legendary English figure has been played on screen by Errol Flynn? Kevin? Elizabeth?
James Bond.
Incorrect. They're over. Kevin Costner and Russell Crowe.
Pass.
Robin Hood. The British actress who won an Academy Award in 2019 for her role in The Favourite is Elizabeth?
Sorry.
Out of time. They're over. Is Olivia who?
Coleman.
Correct. What sea is Bridget Jones's favourite type of white wine? Elizabeth?
Chardonnay.
Correct. Sterling Cooper is the original name of the advertising agency in the US drama series set in the 1960s. Elizabeth?
Mad Men.
Correct. If a British TV actor is said to have joined the Cobbles, which soap opera are they starring in? Elizabeth?
EastEnders.
Incorrect. Throw over.
Coronation Street.
Correct. The actor who reprised his role of Prince Akeem in the 2021 film, Asim?
Coming to America.
It would have been Eddie Murphy. Asim, you are the winner. Congratulations.
Well done.
Well done. Thank you very much.
You're taking it in. Ooh. Can't believe it.
I'm happy that that's done now, that round.
Well, look, last time you went out on that category and now...
In the final.
That's the history. You're into the final.
Yep.
Big bang right there.
Definitely.
Well done. Elizabeth. We have to say goodbye, but thank you for being on the tournament.
Thank you for having me. Well done.
Well, Asim, you have just stolen Elizabeth's £1,010, giving you a nice total of £2,360, and you've qualified for that final. Well done. Okay, Ian, you're in control.
Yeah, I did not expect to be in control. I must admit, I thought Asim were going to pick one of us two.
You know who your opponent is.
I do. She's a good player.
She sure is. Chantal, let's lock you in. You get to decide the category. You have music, food and drink.
Couple of my favourites have already gone, but I'm going to go with music.
Music it is. What sort of music do you listen to?
Probably the stuff that won't come up, like heavy metal and indie, but I have been listening to a lot of music over a lot of years, so hopefully all my years of going to gigs is going to pay off.
OK. Chantal? Music?
Quite an eclectic taste. My mum used to be a music teacher, so I've got a little bit of knowledge, but let's see.
Let's see what happens here. OK, it's time for kick-off in the next of our semi-finals. It's Ian v. Chantal in the category music. Is it funny out there, Ian?
Yeah, I'm more relaxed now I've actually got through a round. I've not totally disgraced myself.
Well, we know you used to play in the part, being an actor. It's time to play the part once again.
Indeed. Hope to play the leading role.
Chantal, you took out a formidable opponent.
I did. So I'm going to be the leading lady.
Nice. Well, let's find out who the favourite is, and I can reveal that the favourite in the category music is... Ian. It's you.
No pressure.
Ian, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Chantal, are you ready?
I'm ready.
You have 2 minutes on the clock, starting in... In which country were the musicians Michael Bublé and Celine Dion? Chantal?
Canada.
Correct. Which leading role in a West End musical was played in the 90s by both Jason Donovan and Philip Schofield? Ian?
Jason.
Incorrect. They're over.
Joseph.
Correct. Which band had hits including Eternal Flame, Manic Monday, Chantal?
Bangles.
Correct. Which reggae band had a UK number one single in 1988 with Don't Turn Around? Chantal?
Red Red Wine.
Incorrect. They're over.
UB40.
Incorrect. Aswad.
Oh, yeah.
Snare, tom-tom and bass. Chantal?
Drum.
Correct. The British jazz musician who has released albums titled Catching Towels and 20-something is Jamie who? Ian?
Colin.
Correct. The singer who danced around a garage with his future wife, Chris... Chantal?
Billy Joel.
Correct. What M is a mechanical device used by musicians to mark time by producing a regular... Ian?
Metronome.
Correct. In the lyrics to the song Hey Ya by Outkast, Ian?
No, come.
Throw over. What brand of camera beginning with P is mentioned?
Polaroid.
Correct. The US rock band who had a UK top 10 hit with Seven Nation Army is, Ian?
White Stripes.
Correct. At a Taylor Swift concert in 2015, actress Lisa Kudrow took to the stage to sing which song made, Ian?
Smelly Cat.
Correct. Which rapper who died in 1996 performed at the 2012 Coachella Festival, Ian?
Tupac.
Except. Back to Bedlam was the number one day. Chantal?
James Blunt.
Correct. Which chart-topping band was formed in the 1980s with Mick Hucknall as lead? Chantal?
Simply Red.
Correct. And it's a win for Chantal! Woo! You are not seeing red there. You did it.
I did. Goodness me. I'm quite surprised by that, actually. I was a bit... I was nervous against Paul, but I saw Ian in the last round and thought, OK, he's good.
So well,
very pleased.
Just like Paul, you've taken out another strong opponent in Ian. Congratulations, Ian.
Well, to be honest, food and drink wasn't my subject either, so I think I was up against a tough opponent, whichever I picked.
Thank you for coming on to the tournament. Chantal, you have just stolen Ian's £450, giving you a total of £800, and you have qualified for the final. Well done.
Thank you very much.
OK, this is it. It's the big one. 8 quizzes are now down to just 2. A huge congratulations, Asim and Chantal. You have both made it to the final, but this time, you are playing to win your own cash pot. For you, Asim, that is a grand total of £2,360. For you, Chantal, that is a grand total of £800. The loser will be going home empty-handed, so it's all to play for. But do remember, if you manage to get a knockout this time, you will have the chance to double your money on the golden run. The category is general knowledge. It's time for kickoff in the final of the tournament. It's Asim v. Chantal. Well, Chantal, you said you wanted to raise some money.
Yep.
Here you are. Yep.
We shall see, shan't we?
What will you do if you win with the money?
We're going on holiday for my husband's big birthday soon, so it'll go towards that, I think.
Where are you planning on going?
We're going to sail over to New York.
Nice. Mm-hmm. OK. And Asim, what would you do with the money?
Similar thing, really. Not been on holiday for a number of years now, so hopefully take the family on a nice trip away.
Planning to go where?
Perhaps Greece. So somewhere that I've not been before, so hopefully that'll be nice.
OK. Well, one of you will be packing that suitcase. We're about to find out who. But before the final gets underway, let's see who the favourite is in the category general knowledge. And I can reveal that it is... Chantal, it's you. Asim, are you ready?
I'm ready.
Chantal, are you ready?
I am ready.
You have 2 minutes on the clock, starting in... In Australia, what season starts in March and ends in May? Chantal?
Winter.
Incorrect. Throwover?
Summer.
Incorrect. Autumn. Which musical beginning with C contains the songs Willkommen and Asim?
Cats.
Incorrect. Throwover and Maybe This Time?
Cabaret.
Correct. Which sharp clawed carnivore with the Latin name Gulo Gulo shares its name with one of the X-Men? Asim?
Wolverine.
Correct. Which Barbara, born in Wakefield, Yorkshire in 1903, was a world famous sculptor? Out of time, Hepworth.
Of course.
The French term which describes someone from abroad who helps with childcare is au what? Asim?
Hair.
Correct. The popular toy named the must-have office toy for 2017 by Forbes magazine was the fidget what? Asim?
Magnet.
Incorrect. Throwover?
Widget.
Incorrect. Spinner. The name of which group of insects can also be used as an acronym for white Anglo-Saxon... Chantal?
Wasp.
Correct. Henry VIII's wife, Catherine of Aragon, was born in which European... Chantal?
Spain.
Correct. What English word beginning with C describes a car that has a folding or detachable roof? Chantal?
Cabriolet.
I'll accept. Which DC comic superhero has the birth name Kal-El? Chantal?
Superman.
Correct. How many sides does a parallelogram have? Asim?
Four.
Correct. Who played Johnny Castle in the 1987 film Dirty Dancing? Chantal?
Patrick Swayze.
Correct. The name of what seed comes... It would have been sesame. You have won, Chantal!
Thank you.
Well done.
Wow.
Some extra money for New York.
Hooray.
Off to the Big Apple right there.
Yeah. Gosh, I'm amazed. Great opponent. Thank you, Asim.
Well done, well done.
You managed it all the way through, taking out strong opponent after strong opponent.
Gosh.
You did it.
Yay, I did. I'm so pleased.
I'll let you take it in a moment. So close.
So close yet so far, but no, worthy winner.
Thank you very much, Asim.
Well, thank you for being on the tournament. But a huge congratulations, Chantal. You have just won yourself £800. You can start packing that suitcase. You are off. Well done. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Thank you. And well done.
Ooh, well done. Well, can one of our players match that or do better next time on the tournament? The game where starting out in pole position is not good enough. The only thing that matters is reaching the checkered flag. We'll see you next time. Goodbye.